I've been cleared of that airport shoot. I realize you like your little sexual fantasies. But when I'm gone, you need to be more cautious. You need to stay away from that window.
Sorry to hear about that.
Sure,
don't
mess around.
Yes, we are.
We sure.
Well, Lee, so good to see you. So glad you're able to come. Oh, incidentally, over here, my good friend. This is my friend here. Lee, I want you to meet my daughter, Zelda.
What? Pleasure to meet you.
Sorry to hear about your mother.
Thank you. I'll miss her.
And also, this is my son, Sammy.
Nice meeting you. Glad you could come.
And this is his lovely wife, Helen.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
So, this way things happen. You know. Lee, come to think of it, I'd like for you to sit with us at the church.
Mm-hmm.
shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Gang. Well, the limo's here. Let's go.
Hard to believe that she's gone. I've been seeing her in church almost every Sunday. Hard to believe it.
Man, I tell you, I would like to know. It's just, you know, pleasure meeting all of us. Maybe we could just met under different circumstances. I wouldn't really know what to do, what to say.
I'm gonna miss Mama. She was a good cook, and that's one thing I can say I inherited from Mama. I know she's watched me every time it's a sunny day. I know Mama's smiling. It's coming my way. And I miss you, Mama, and I love you.
Good morning. I keep thinking back when I was a kid and how she helped me out. And I
just can't believe it.
Remember, she always go over to the house and fix those warm apple pies.
She was a good cook, wasn't she?
Yeah.
I'm gonna miss her a lot too.
I'm gonna miss her. I don't know how I'm gonna get along without her. She always treated me just like a daughter. She was such a good woman to everybody. Just to everybody.
Yeah, she mended my clothes, always looking out for me.
She helped me find God. And I won't have her to talk to anymore.
Well, what do you think of my farm here, Lee?
Nice little place.
It certainly is. And let me tell you, it's a lot of work on this tobacco farm. A lot of work. Not easy. You got a lot of land out here. Yep. Of course, my boy Sammy, you know, he's married. And his wife, Helen, good kids. Now, the only one I got is not married yet, but I'm looking forward to her getting married. Zelda. Very beautiful daughter. Very sweet girl. Incidentally, You ever thought about getting married, Lee?
Well, it's a thought.
I know you're being a drifter. Incidentally, listen, I've been a drifter in my life, too, before I got all this. And let me tell you, I've been through it, man. Texas, Arizona, had some rugged times on them roads and highways. It's a rough life. But I kind of miss it in a way, but it's not like having your own place. You can really enjoy it. It's yours. Do what you like with it. Work when you want to work. Raise a family. What do you think, kid?
It's a thought.
Yeah. Anyway, I think be nice if you and Zelda get together. You know, I'm kind of hitting to you, kid, but I think you find her to be a nice girl. Two people can get together and do, you know, wonders. What do you think?
It's a thought.
I knew I'd count on you, pal.
And he won't hear of adoption. We could adopt children.
Well, if we did that, it wouldn't really be his name if it's carrying on.
But if we adopt an infant, we could bring that child up just like one of us.
Well, he don't look at it, by the way.
So instead, we'll marry your sister off to breed her.
Well, I don't think much of that Ryan fella.
I don't either.
I wish I'd never saw him. He's nothing but trouble, the way I look at it.
He's just after your daddy's money.
That's what I'm thinking.
I'll be right out.
Dad is really glad to see you stay on. You're just like a son to him.
Well, this feels just like home to me.
I just stopped by to see how you were making it.
Well, thank you very much, Jim. I'm glad you were concerned. Yep, 2 weeks already. Man, it's hard to take. Martha's not with us no more. It's sad. Real sad. Great girl. A real pal. She was there when I always needed her. She was a real partner. And raising those two kids, Sammy and Zelda. I mean, what a mother. But it was sad the way she had to go. I don't know, I just can't get over it, man. I'm shaking up over it. But I gotta continue working around here. Gotta keep things rolling. But that's the way Martha would want it. Yeah?
I heard that Mr. Ryan is still with you.
Yeah. Yeah, he's still working for me. Nice boy. Nice boy.
I thought it over. And I'm not going to run for the next election. And I'll take that foreman's job if you'll have me.
You mean you're going to quit being our local sheriff? I never thought it would come to that end. You did a super job. People in this area think the world of you. You always had my vote. But if you want to hook up with me, kid, you're welcome to it. My word is my bond. You want that job, Jim, you got it.
Thank you very much.
You know, I was hoping my boy would have some children by now. You know, after 5, 6 years now, you know, hey, when are they going to have some kids?
Yeah.
You know, and after all my age, you know, how much longer am I going to be around?
That's right.
So, yeah, I kind of hope my boy would do something. After all, he's got a, when I'm gone, they're going to have a lot of property.
Hey, Todd, I heard you and Mark. Listen.
You won't say nothing. Okay, now you're there.
Watch it, buddy. Hey, you.
Give me the money now.
It's collection time, Charlie. Collection time.
Okay, what's the news? The girl's still there.
Y'all say that you men haven't got your guns with you. Well, you should have brought them.
Future son-in-law.
Future son-in-law?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, right. Don't you know what you're doing? You're putting that stranger ahead of your own flesh and blood. And you're pushing somebody on Zelda all the time.
Not really. Listen, after all, when he married Zelda, I got my fingers crossed. And after all, he's a nice boy. He's helping me around here.
I mean, he's
going out of his way. I mean, after all, how many people would actually do that? And if he marries Zelda, I'm willing to give up 50 acres. And of course, Sammy's got the other 50.
Right, right.
Sammy's going to be in control of things around here.
Uh-huh.
And it's going to be Zelda's as well. And Zelda is going to have to eventually get married. I mean, it's not living in a big city where she's going to go out and make her big choice of different people around. I mean, it's a small place. After all, I got a feeling that she's kind of falling in love with the guy.
Oh, okay. Well,
she's very pretty.
Yes.
Aren't you, darling? Ain't you, baby? Tell me.
Yeah. I took after Mother.
That's right.
I took after Mother. Mother would let me make up my own mind, Daddy.
Uh-huh. That's true.
Yeah.
Martha would.
She would.
Mm-hmm. She really would.
You know, I know your dad really wants kids. He wants us to have kids. And it's not that I don't want to. I'm just really afraid of that operation. It's dangerous. And they said I might not even make it through it. Doesn't he understand that?
Dad does want grandchildren bad to carry on his name. But it is a serious operation.
I just happened to be at the right place at the right time and did the right thing. Your father sees everything in me that I want him to see in me, and I feel good about it. You know what he's got in mind for the both of us. He wants us to get married.
It's gotta be Jim!
Yeah!
Come on in, boy! Come on in!
Hello, Sheriff.
Good morning, Claudette.
You're
Mr. Ralph.
Running late today.
Zelda.
Good morning.
Thought I'd stop by and have a cup of coffee with you.
Yeah, we got that coffee
get
for
a cup
you.
Of coffee.
We got plenty of coffee.
Have a seat. Right here.
Thank you.
You're running late today.
Yes, I know. It's that things has been hectic today and...
What, the troublemakers down at the bar again?
That's right.
All
the troublemakers
right.
Driving me up a wall.
What they've done this time?
Robinson, I hear you got a big farm here. How about showing me around?
Sure, why not? Why not? Big enough. Plenty here to do. And it's weird. The older you get, seems like there's always so much work to be done. Sometimes it seems like it's never, never done. But I tell you, I mean, I had good health, really good health. And, you know, that's what counts. I always feel, you know, you're good as your health. If your health is good, it makes me good. You make me look good. You being here, that tops it off. You being an old farm boy here down, you know the game.
I've never worked on a 100-acre farm, so...
Yeah, but you'll get used to it. And I got news. I'm gonna miss you being a sheriff around here.
Yeah.
In fact, I was gonna vote for you next time. Okay. Now, let me show you around, Jim.
Fine.
Good man. Good man. Good man.
God, are you all right?
Oh. Nice and slow.
Thank you.
You know, Helen, it's nice to get out like this and listen to the crickets and a nice walk and be together in the quietness of the farm and just look over the farm and all the farmland and walk around it and go back to nature and listen to the crickets and the birds sing with old Bubba coming along walking with us. Isn't it great?
It is. It's really nice.
Really great.
I just hope we don't have to lose part of this.
Me too. That's really got me worried. Seemed like things are going so good, now here comes trouble.
I know. And you've worked so hard for your dad. And you've just given him your all.
No, it's just, I don't know what we're going to do, but it's really got me worried. It really has. I hope things will work out soon. If only that Ryan guy had not come into the picture.
Just some way to get rid of him.
Yeah, and Zelda seems to be so much in love with him. I hope it's some way that she can see the light and see what him for what he really is. But time will tell.
While the men are out in the fields working, I need to have a talk with you.
Okay.
Your father is putting Lee Ryan ahead of Sammy, his own flesh and blood. I don't understand that.
Colette, you're reading this all wrong. Daddy's reliving his childhood. It helps keep him young to buddy around with Lee Ryan. You've just got to understand that.
Okay, I understand. But your father needs to put more interest in this family and his son Sammy.
Keeping things rolling, looking good all the time. Yeah, the cattle, background. Yeah. Cheerful place, romantic. Everything what a man really needs. It comes with living, you know, the way you want to make things happen. It's really up to you. Hear that cattle?
Farmland, I tell you.
They can always hear it when the master speaks. That means they're happy as well. Harmony, harmony. What a life. It beats that old city life.
Well, that's something to think about. It's...
Dressed
up today.
Lee, there's
going to
be a memorial Sunday for Mother and her memory, and I want you to be there.
Well, look, Zell, I'm not that good a singer. I'm liable just to mess up the service.
All I want you to do is be there is for Mother, okay?
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Sort of a man-to-man talk.
Okay. Shoot, Dad.
Yeah. Would it really help to have some grandchildren? So they could go on and carry my name.
Look, Dad. Helen will have to have an operation to have children. And it might not go well. I feel like it should be our decision to have children, not yours.
Yeah, let me tell you, Sam. My firstborn, Anna. Lovely girl. She got married to a fellow that was really twice her age. Nice man. But the poor man died of a heart attack before he produced any children. Too bad. Too bad.
Hey, Sam?
No, thanks, Dad. Not right now.
It's fresh.
People don't get married for breeding purposes. That's why Anna left home. She got tired of hearing it.
Charlie.
Till I get back.
How you gonna die?
Fine. Thank you very much, Mr. Johnson.
Yes, so, Conrad, what's on your mind?
Well, a few things.
Tell me about it.
Well, actually, I want you to draw up a contract for me. Mr. Johnson, I need for you to write up a contract for me. I'm offering 50 acres of my land to David Lee Ryan, providing that he marries my daughter. And of course, I want this in writing.
Mr. Robertson, if I didn't know you better, I'd think that you was trying to persuade Mr. Ryan into marrying your daughter.
Now, I'm a pretty good judge of characters. Now, Lee wants to marry my daughter, Zelda. And of course, I know he's not marrying her for the land.
Mr. Robertson, that's not a good idea. Now, you know that marriages don't always work out. And if they go their separate ways, Mr. Ryan will have the land. Now, my advice to you is put the land in your daughter's name. That way, the land will always stay in the family.
No. No, I want Mr. Ryan's name on that contract.
So be it, Mr. Robertson. But I've got to give you my personal advice. After all, that's what you're paying me for.
Did you see that? He's putting that Ryan over his own flesh and blood.
Yeah. I would sure like to have some grandchildren so they can go on, carry my name. Carry my name through.
Mr. Robertson, I understand that you like to hang around Lee Ryan. And you're always on Zelda about getting married. But you need to show more interest in your son, Sammy. And this family.
I have some grandchildren. So they could go on and carry my name.
Yeah. I hear that you're gonna sign half of that land over to that stranger Ryan if he marries Zelda. I just don't think that's right.
Well, I understand what you're saying, Sam. But you gotta remember, Zelda's gonna have to get married. And after all, I kinda like that boy. He's not a bad boy. I know he's, you know, we don't know that much about him. But, you know, getting to know him. I like him. I know you like him as well. And of course, I know Zelda's in love. So that's what's important. Of course, he's going to get 50%. But you got to remember, it's going to belong to Zelda as well. And we got to make sure that she's happy. And she's way overdue getting married. So I kind of feel that I think that's fair enough.
Hi, Helen. How are you?
I'll tell you the truth, Zelda, I'm not sure.
What's wrong?
There's so much stuff going on around here. I just don't know. I've just been worried to death. Worried sick for Sammy. It's this stuff with this Ryan guy is about to drive him crazy. And your daddy, he's acting like a, I don't know, he acts like he's 14 years old.
Yeah, he enjoys being around Lee. He really does. He makes him feel young again. And, you know, daddy wants to see me marry this guy.
But do you want to marry this guy?
There's a chance I may. I just don't know, Helen. I just don't know.
But what do you know about him?
I know he's a nice guy.
Well, I've worked these fields by the sweat of my brow. And I've heard if you marry my sister, you're going to get half of the farm. And it's just not right. It's just not right.
Well, I mean, the way I hear it, your father has over 100 acres of land. Now, the way I see it, if I don't marry your sister, I mean, somebody else will. And the way I see it, I'm just as entitled to the land as them.
No. No, Pa just wouldn't sign that land over to just anybody.
Well, you've got a good-looking sister. I mean, I can say that. Good-looking sister.
My father stopped trying to talk that Ryan man into marrying my younger sister, Zelda. And if he does, half of that farmland will go to him.
Well, Sammy, you still have half. Well, that's quite a bit the way I look at it. So how much is enough?
Well, it's just not right. I've worked them fields from daylight till dark by the sweat of my brow. It's just not right that an outsider can come in here and take it like that.
You know, that's not right, that man getting your land like that.
Yeah, we got a score to settle with that man.
Why don't you bust him up when he comes back in here?
I'd like to, but no, we've had enough trouble on this place. Let me tell you this, there's a place for it.
Mr. Brown.
Yes, sir. How you doing?
Just fine. Are you?
Just fine.
I just stopped by to let you know that Bill and myself will be furnishing refreshments for the workers in the field.
That's good. That's good. Glad to hear that. Glad to hear that. We need all the help we can get someday.
Hope that you get ready and come to church later on.
Oh, yes, sir. I'll be there.
Good. Look forward to seeing you.
Mm-hmm.
Good day.
Good day.
I want to thank each and every one of you for coming to worship tonight. I'm the Reverend David Lee Ryan. Oh, I see John Doe over here. Thank you for coming, John. He runs this house of prostitution across the street. Mingles with his prostitutes. Yet he believes in the verse John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. I'm here to tell you, John, you leave these prostitutes alone. You give up your sinful ways. That verse is not going to get you to heaven. I'm here to tell you, John, as far as you and these other men, you give up your sinful ways and turn your life over to the Lord, or you'll be chasing these whores in hell. Now let me refer to you to Romans chapter 10, verse 13. Whoever shall call on the name of the Lord will be saved. But that means you turn over your sinful ways. Give up your sinful ways and turn your life over to the Lord. What I wanted to announce is that my uncle, Charles Wilson, he died in the hospital last night. He was attacked by one of these street gangs here in New York by demanding money for protection. There's nothing we can do for Uncle Charles outside of giving him a decent burial, but what it is, we can spread the gospel to help the living.
You know, Zell, there's something that we need to talk about. Zell, I tell you, I can't take this farm life. Getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, slopping the hogs, working the fields. I want to go back to the factory and work. I will marry you, but I want you to come with me.
Wait. This is the only life I've ever known. I'll marry you, but you've got to stay here and help me work the fields because this is all I've ever done.
Stickers all over. What'd you say about your tool shed?
I bought a lock and put it on the tool shed.
You did?
And locked up our tools.
Well, we've never done that before.
You know, Dad, but this day and time, you can't take any chances on somebody stealing our tools.
Well, I doubt it. But, after all, this is your place as well as mine, so whatever you do, it's fine with me.
Leroy's doing a good job on the farm for Mr. Robertson.
Is that right?
Yeah, he is. But I tell you, Mr. Robertson needs to pay more attention to Sammy.
Well, you know that I don't feel like that Sammy likes me too good.
Oh, no, he don't.
Because I know that Sammy had spoke to me a time or two about Lee Ryan. So that's the reason I'm telling you that I don't think Sammy likes him too good.
Yeah, I understand.
But there's nothing I can do. My hands are tied.
Well, I can't do nothing either. I just work for Mr. Robertson. I mean, I've already said a little bit. Yeah,
I know.
So you're going to lock her up, is that right, Sammy?
Well, Dad, we already got it locked. But I got a tool in here that I'd like to get your opinion on. That's
okay.
A new tool that I bought.
Because I don't think I'd have any problems out here, somebody stealing anything. But okay, show me what you got there, Sammy.
A
I'd like for you to look over there at that tool. Check that tool out.
With you. Sammy, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid.
Old man, I've took a lot of junk off of you, but when you decided to sign this land over to that stranger, when it belongs to Zelda and me, you went too far. You're gonna roast for this, because I'm gonna burn this building down with you in it.
With you. Sammy, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid. Get me out of here. Sammy, get me out of here.
Get it, Sammy. You were gonna burn me up. I don't get it. Your change of heart. Does that mean you love me? Let's get out of here. I tell you, really had me frightened.
Hey, Rose, are you okay? Are you okay?
Let's clean where that come from. Tell me more where that come from. You're a very good son.
Oh, Zelda. I'll be right out. You know, Zelda, I hear that Helen's in the hospital. What's wrong?
Well, you know, they had been talking about the operation so that Helen could have the grandchildren Daddy always wanted, and they finally came to an agreement, and that's what's going on. Lee, I want to thank you for not fighting with my brother Sammy. I know you did it to help keep unity within this family.
Well, I can't really take a whole lot of credit. I mean, your brother has, so he's got a good right.
I tell you.
What's up, Dan?
You know, running this farm is... it's not as easy as it looks. But I'm going to tell you right now, the way that things are right now situated, the crop was actually my prop, my fault. I let the men off last week, which I shouldn't have let the boys go, I mean, you know. But anyway, that tobacco up there is starting to get ripe. And it's got to move. I mean, we've got to move it quick. Otherwise, we're going to be in trouble with this stuff.
Well, don't worry, Dad. We'll have enough help, but all of them just can't work at the same time. So what we'll do, we'll run two crews, one in the morning and one in the evening.
You know what? It's a good idea. Now you know why I got you, my number one son.
Well, that being the case, I don't guess it'd bother Mr. Robinson too much about me leaving. I mean, after all, he sees
His son now what he used to seeing me.
Thank you, ladies, for all that you've done for me. Well, I'm just going to have to break the news to Mr. Robinson. I'll have to be on the way.
I'm glad that you were here with us. I fixed you a little something for the long trip.
Thank you very much.
Clay, whenever you reach your destination, please keep in touch, and we'll write back, okay?
I will.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Robson, I don't have to tell you this, but, well, I'm just not going to be able to make it to church today. Well, me and Zelda, we decided that we want to live in our own worlds, and, well, I'll be going my own way.
Well, Lee, I hope there's no hard feelings.
No, Sam, you pack a good punch, a real good punch.
Well, best of luck, my boy. Best of luck to you.
Thank you, Mr. Robson.
See you, man. What a guy. Sam, I give you a lot of credit. Punching that guy out.
You threw a kick to his stomach, knocking the breath out of him. Then when you had him where you wanted him, just like a kicker in football trying for a goal, you did that karate kick and you knocked him in the jaw so hard that you snapped his neck, driving his body to the ground. He was out of breath and out of commission, and you kept on in your rage.
You know, I think we got an awful storm headed this way. I'm just hoping that the roof in the jail don't leak.
Isn't it true you were sent to the Biloxi Hospital for the criminally insane, for killing a man.
Sergeant Gray! No, you're Sergeant Gray! I'm dead weight. You're right. You know, this little scuffle jogged my memory, Mr. Williams. I hope you really feel good about your treatment of the prisoners in Vietnam. I hope you really feel good about it. Mr. Williams, we lost a lot of men over there. Killed by people that we thought we were protecting. There are certain areas infiltrated with VC. It's my responsibility to get to the truth. So you had to get to the truth. At the expense of making the innocent pay. And you show no remorse about it. No remorse to the prisoners that we helped capture. And just how much remorse do you think they show for our crews? Some of them have their testicles cut out and crammed down their throat. That's a hard way to die. These were soldiers, served their country. Same way we was called to serve ours. And you made the innocent pay for what the guilty did. Nevertheless, I never killed any of the prisoners. Oh, I made them think I was going to kill them. I was just trying to find the destination port of the enemy. Get to the truth. I was just trying to keep my men alive. Well, you didn't keep me alive.
Tell me what happened.
I had a fight with the demon within. I know who I am now. You're right. I'm Sergeant William S. Gray. Mr. Williams served in my platoon in Vietnam. We had a conflict. He didn't like the way that I treated the prisoners. After the war ended, Mr. Williams went on to get married. As the years went by, his wife passed away. So his purpose in life was to track me down. I don't know the motive. Maybe it was revenge. Yet when he got to me, and was struggled. His head hit the ground too hard. When I was committed, I was ate up with guilt, depression, anxiety. My only means of survival was to become Mr. Williams. By keeping Mr. Williams alive, it relieved the guilt. I changed my name to Billy Williams. Yeah, I kept my own Social Security number, my service number. Other identification remained the same. That's why that when I got out, everything mashed up with my driver's license.
You did? Now, isn't that the truth? And the truth is, you're convicting yourself. Now, isn't that the truth?
Say what? You're turning me loose. I understand that the man that I struggled with at the plant was a prisoner out on parole. I can see why he didn't press charges. Thank you for your help, officer. I am the Reverend David Lee Ryan. I call this special meeting because I know that a lot of you are terrorized by these street gangs demanding protection money. What I'm saying is, I've talked with law enforcement, and what they tell me is, they haven't got enough evidence to indict these people, much less convict them in a court of law. And a lot of it comes from you not giving them the information. Yet I can understand why my Uncle Charlie, he stood up against him and he's dead. I'm a minister in this community, and any of you that have me in your home, just give me their description. It'll be all done in the name of home ministry. Give me their description, and I will report it to law enforcement. And if the gang comes after me, so be it. What I'm saying is, I can understand why that you can't come forward to law enforcement. I mean, what I'm saying, my Uncle Charlie, he is dead.
But what I'm saying is, a home minister, I can come to your home, give me their description, I will go to law enforcement. And if the gang chooses to come to me, well, they'll be coming after me instead of you. Well, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming. And my calling in the ministry is just a whole lot more than knowing a word by word in this Bible. I don't know it word by word, but what it is, I carry this Bible. It's got the table of contents in front. I can refer you to any scripture that you ask. But what I'm saying is, part of my ministry is to do goodwill for my fellow man. And if I can help you people in this community, well, that's my calling. Thank you for inviting me. I'm Dr. William C. Craig, Chief Psychiatrist at the Biloxi Mental Hospital. The man you're dealing with is not David Lee Ryan. It's Sergeant William S. Gray. This man was a platoon leader in Vietnam. He's seen action in combat, but he mistreated the prisoners. He felt that he was doing the right thing at the time by finding an enemy's destination point. There's one man in his platoon that stood up against him, Billy Williams, and he just beat him bad, made an example out of him in his platoon.
I heard a lot about him. He's one of those military guys.
When Mr. Gray returned to the States, this stage of maturity hit him. So he went into a deep spell of anxiety. Also, this Billy Williams, he went to school, took karate. So he met Sergeant William S. Gray, he said a lot of dead, and what happened was, Mr. Gray threw him to the cement, slammed his head on the cement, and Billy Williams was dead. So he went into a deep spell of anxiety. He was committed at the Biloxi Mental Hospital. His only escape was to become the people of goodwill. He became Billy Williams. What it is, there's David Lee Ryan. He was a missionary in Vietnam at that time. He witnessed to Sergeant William S. Gray somewhere between the Cambodian border. As the years went by, David Lee Ryan became an ordained Baptist minister. He went to Iraq and Iran on a goodwill tour to help the people of that country. He was executed. He was beheaded during the Gulf War. And anyway, David Lee Ryan became him. He just felt the need to minister to people with goodwill. Undoubtedly, he met Mr. Robinson sometime before his wife died. So he came to Mr. Robinson's wife's funeral, found refuge on Robinson Farm. What it is, Sergeant William S. Gray, he becomes people of goodwill. But all the people of goodwill that he goes by their name, they're dead. He believes he's them. What it is, when Mr. Robinson Boy pushed him out on the farm over a land dispute, he didn't harm him. So we feel we've helped that band that way. He won't harm an honest citizen. But this warrior is a combat soldier still there, and you can see the results on the streets. Possibly if this man is indicted by trial. Well, maybe it's best that he's sent back to the Black's Mental Hospital. Maybe it's best. Thank you for inviting me. I tell you, we've got a lot of snow down here on the way down. I took a Greyhound bus. And I got to this town, but after that, the buses just don't travel out in this particular area. Well, I just want to thank you for stopping for me. You know, it'd been a long walk if it weren't for you.
Glad to help. Where are you from?
Well, I'm from the mental hospital. I've been there for 20 years.
Is that right?
I came to, been writing a woman to these parts for the last 14 years, and I've been wanting to go see her. That's where I'm headed right now.
It's been a lot of snow up there the last couple of days, and I don't think I'm going to be able to drive up there. Mrs. Manning lives up there at the top of the hill, and I just don't think I'm going to try to drive up there.
Well, I tell you, I thank you for the ride, and I never did ask you your name.
name's Steve Thomason.
Well, it's really nice to meet you, Mr. Thomason, and I guess I'll be on my way now.
Okay.
Picture showed that you was a much younger man.
Well, it's an old picture, but...
Have a seat and I'll get you a cup of coffee.
Well, I guess you realize I've been away for 20 years, so... I don't believe you're expecting a real young man.
No. I think they would have been disappointed if you'd have been as young as your picture showed.
Well, have you been making it?
Been making it pretty good. How's life been treating you?
Well, I'm just glad to get out. Yeah, you're right about your dog being killed. I didn't know. Did you want to go out and visit his grave?
We could, if you want to. I mean, a lot of guys ain't all that interested in things like that. But I am glad that you showed an interest.
Quite welcome.
serve us something?
Sorry to hear about that.
Sure, go mess around.
Yes, we are.
Sure. Well, Lee, so good to see you. So glad you were able to come. Oh, incidentally, over here, my good friend. This is my friend here. Lee, I want you to meet my daughter, Zelda.
What? Pleasure to meet you.
Sorry to hear about your mother.
Thank you. I'll miss her.
And also, this is my son, Sammy.
Nice meeting you. Glad you could come.
And this is his lovely wife, Helen.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
So, this way things happen, you know. Lee, come to think of it, I like for you to sit with us at the church.
If I can help you people in this community, well, that's my calling. Thank you for inviting me. I'm Dr. William C. Gregg, Chief Psychiatrist at the Biloxi Mental Hospital. The man you're dealing with is not David Lee Ryan. It's Sergeant William S. Gregg. This man was the platoon leader in Vietnam. He's seen action in combat. But he mistreated the prisoners. He felt that he was doing the right thing at the time by finding an enemy's destination point. There's one man in his platoon that stood up against him, Billy Williams, and he just beat him bad, made it south wide of him, in his platoon.
I heard a lot about him. He's one of those military guys.
When Mr. Gray returned to the stage, the stage of maturity hit him. So he went into a deep spell of anxiety. Also, this Billy Williams, he went to school, took karate.
Tell me what happened.
I had a fight with the demon within. I know who I am now. You're right. I'm Sergeant William S. Gray. Mr. Williams served in my platoon in Vietnam. We had a conflict. He didn't like the way that I treated the prisoners. After the war ended, Mr. Williams went on to get married. As the years went by, his wife passed away. So his purpose in life was to track me down. I don't know the motive. Maybe it was revenge. Yet when he got to me, and we struggled. His head hit the ground too hard. When I was committed, I was ate up with guilt, depression, anxiety. My only means of survival was to become Mr. Williams. By keeping Mr. Williams alive, it relieved the guilt. I changed my name to Billy Williams. Yeah, I kept my own Social Security number, my service number. Other identification remained the same. That's why that when I got out, everything matched up with my driver's license.
You did it. Now, isn't that the truth? And the truth is, you're convicting yourself. Now, isn't that the truth?
So, you're turning me loose. I understand that the man that I struggled with at the plant was a prisoner out on parole. I can see why he didn't press charges. Thank you for your help, officer.
You threw a kick to his stomach, knocking the breath out of him. Then when you had him where you wanted him, just like a kicker in football trying for a goal, you did that karate kick and you knocked him in the jaw so hard that you snapped his neck, driving his body to the ground.
You know, after 5-6 years now, you know, hey, when are they gonna have some kids?
Yeah.
You know, and after all my age, you know, how much longer am I gonna be around?
That's right.
So, yeah, I kind of hope my boy would do something. After all, he's got a, when I'm gone, they're gonna have a lot of property.
Hey, Kyle, I heard you married. Listen.
Watch it, buddy.
Give me the money now.
It's collection time, Charlie. Collection time.
Okay, what's the news? The girl's still there.
Y'all say that you men haven't got your guns with you. Well, you should have brought them.
Future son-in-law.
Future son-in-law?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, right. Don't you know what you're doing? You're putting that stranger ahead of your own flesh and blood. And you're pushing somebody on Zelda all the time.
Not really. Listen, after all, when he marries Zelda, I got my fingers crossed. And after all, he's a nice boy. He's helping me around here.
I mean, he's
going out of his way. I mean, after all, how many people would actually do that?
If he...
Me too. That's really got me worried. Seemed like things are going so good. Now here comes trouble.
I know. And you've worked so hard for your dad. And you've just given him your all.
No, it's just, I don't know what we're going to do, but it's really got me worried. It really has. I hope things will work out soon. If only that Ryan guy had not come into the picture.
Just some way to get rid of him.
Yeah, and Zelda seems to be so much in love with him. I hope it's some way that she can see the light and see what him for what he really is. But time will tell.
I know.
While the men are out in the fields working, I need to have a talk with you. Your father is putting Lee Ryan ahead of Sammy, his own flesh and blood. I don't understand that.
Colette, you're reading this all wrong. Daddy's reliving his childhood. It helps keep him young to buddy around with Lee Ryan. You've just got to understand that.
Well, Okay, I understand. But your father needs to put more interest in this family and his son, Sammy.
Keeping things rolling, looking good all the time. Hear the cattle? Background. Yeah. Cheerful place, romantic. Everything what a man really needs. It comes with living, you know, the way you want to make things happen. It's really up to you. Hear that cattle?
What Dave Lee Ryan? It's Sergeant William S. Gray. This man was a platoon leader in Vietnam. He's seen action in combat, but he mistreated the prisoners. He felt that he was doing the right thing at the time by finding an enemy's destination point. There's one man in his platoon that stood up against him, Billy Williams, and he just beat him bad, made an example out of him in his platoon.
I heard a lot about him. He's one of those military guys.
When Mr. Gray returned to the stage, the stage of maturity hit him. So he went into a deep spell of anxiety. Also, this Billy Williams, he went to school, took karate. So he met Sergeant William S. Gray, he said a lot of dead, and what happened was, Mr. Gray threw him to the cement, slammed his head on the cement, and Billy Williams was dead. So he went into a deep spell of anxiety. He was committed at the Black's Mental Hospital. His only escape was to become the people of goodwill. He became Billy Williams. What it is, there's David Lee Ryan. He was a missionary in Vietnam at that time. He witnessed to Sergeant William S. Gray somewhere between the Cambodian border. As the years went by, David Lee Ryan became an ordained Baptist minister. He went to Iraq and Iran on a goodwill tour to help the people of that country. He was executed. He was beheaded during the Gulf War. And anyway, David Lee Ryan became him. He just felt the need to minister to people with goodwill. Undoubtedly, he met Mr. Robinson sometime before his wife died. So he came to Mr. Robinson's wife's funeral, found refuge on Robinson Farm. What it is, Sergeant William S. Gray, he becomes people of goodwill. But all the people of goodwill that he goes by their name, they're dead. He believes he's them. What it is, killed by people that we thought we were protecting. There are certain areas infiltrated with VC. It's my responsibility to get to the truth. So you had to get to the truth at the expense of making the innocent pay. And you show no remorse about it. No remorse to the prisoners that we have captured. And just how much remorse do you think they show for our troops? Some of them have their testicles cut out and crammed down their throat. That's a hard way to die. These were soldiers. Served their country. Same way we was called to serve ours. And you made the innocent pay for what the guilty did. Nevertheless, I never killed any of the prisoners. Oh, I made them think I was going to kill them. I was just trying to find the destination port of the enemy. Get to the truth. I was just trying to keep my men alive. Well, you didn't keep me alive.
Tell me what happened.
I had a fight with the demon within. I know who I am now. You're right. I'm Sergeant William S. Gray. Mr. Williams served in my platoon in Vietnam. We had a conflict. He didn't like the way that I treated the prisoners. After the war ended, Mr. Williams went on to get married. As the years went by, his wife passed away. So his purpose in life was to track me down. I don't know the motive. Maybe it was revenge. Yet when he got to me,
and Zelda seems to be so much in love with him. I hope it's some way that she can see the light and see what him for what he really is. But time will tell.
I know.
One of the men are out in the fields working. I need to have a talk with you.
Okay.
Your father is putting Lee Ryan ahead of Sammy, his own flesh and blood. I don't understand that.
Colette, you're reading this all wrong. Daddy's reliving his childhood. It helps keep him young to buddy around with Lee Ryan. You've just got to understand that.
Okay, I understand. But your father needs to put more interest in this family and his son, Sammy.
Keeping things rolling, looking good all the time. Hear the cattle? Background. Yeah. Cheerful place. Romantic. Everything what a man really needs. Comes with living, you know, the way you want to make things happen. It's really up to you. Hear the cattle?
Farmland, I tell you.
They can always hear it when the master speaks. That means they're happy as well. Harmony, harmony. What a life. It beats that old city life.
Well, that's something to think about. It's
Zell, I see you're all dressed up today.
Leroy's doing a good job on the farm for Mr. Robertson.
Is that right?
Yeah, he is. But I tell you, Mr. Robertson needs to pay more attention to Sammy.
Well, you know that I don't feel like that Sammy likes me too good.
Oh, no, he don't.
Because I know that Sammy had spoke to me a time or two about Lee Ryan. So that's the reason I'm telling you that I don't think Sammy likes him too good.
Yeah, I understand.
There's nothing I can do. My hands are tied.
Well, I can't do nothing either. I just work for Mr. Robertson. I mean, I've already said a little bit. Yeah,
I know.
So you're going to lock her up, is that right, Sammy?
Well, Dad already got it locked. But I got a tool in here that I'd like to get your opinion on. That's
okay.
A new tool that I bought.
Because I don't think I'd have any problems out here, somebody stealing anything. But okay, show me what you got there, Sammy.
I'd like for you to look over there at that tool. Check that tool out.
Sam, what is it with you? Sam, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid.
Old man, I've took a lot of junk off of you, but when you decided to sign this land over to that stranger, when it belongs to Zelda and me, you went too far. You're gonna roast for this, because I'm gonna burn this building down with you in it.
With you. Sammy, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid. Get me out of here. Sammy, get me out of here. Get it, Sammy. You were gonna burn me up. I don't get it. Your change of heart. Does that mean you love me? Let's get out of here.
People don't get married for breeding purposes. That's why Anna left home. She got tired of hearing it.
Charlie, Uncle Charlie.
Celeste, back. I'm gonna call somebody. I'm gonna call the police.
How you gonna die?
Fine. Thank you very much, Mr. Johnson.
Yes, so, Conrad, what's on your mind?
Well, a few things.
Tell me about them.
Well, actually, I want you to draw up a contract for me. Mr. Johnson, I need for you to write up a contract for me. I'm offering 50 acres of my land to David Lee Ryan, providing that he marries my daughter. And of course, I want this in writing.
Mr. Robertson, if I didn't know you better, I'd think that you was trying to persuade Mr. Ryan into marrying your daughter.
I call this special meeting because I know that a lot of you are terrorized by these street gangs demanding protection money. What I'm saying is, I've talked with law enforcement, and what they tell me is they haven't got enough evidence to indict these people, much less convict them in a court of law. And a lot of it comes from you not giving them the information. Yet I can understand why my Uncle Charlie, he stood up against him and he's dead. Now, I'm a minister in this community. And any of you that have me in your home, just give me their description. It'll be all done in the name of home ministry. Give me their description, and I will report it to law enforcement. And if the gang comes after me, so be it. What I'm saying is, I can understand why that you can't come forward to law enforcement. I mean, what I'm saying, my Uncle Charlie, he is dead. But what I'm saying is, a home minister, I can come to your home. Give me their description. I will go to law enforcement. And if the gang chooses to come to me, well, they'll be coming out to me instead of you. Well, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming. And my calling in the ministry is just a whole lot more than knowing a word by word in this Bible. I don't know it word by word, but what it is, I carry this Bible. It's got the table of contents in front. I can refer you.
recognize you. Come on in. Your picture showed that you was a much younger man.
Well, it's an old picture, but...
Have a seat and I'll get you a cup of coffee.
Well, I guess you realize I've been away for 20 years, so I don't believe you're expecting a real young man.
No. I think I'd have been disappointed if you'd have been as young as your picture showed.
Well, have you been making it?
Been making it pretty good. How's life been treating you?
Well, I'm just glad to get out. You wrote about your dog being killed. I didn't know. Did you want to go out and visit his grave?
Well, we could, if you want to. I mean, a lot of guys ain't all that interested in things like that. But I am glad that you showed an interest.
I need for you to write up a contract for me. I'm offering 50 acres of my land to David Lee Ryan, providing that he marries my daughter. And of course, I want this in writing.
Mr. Robertson, if I didn't know you better, I'd think that you was trying to persuade Mr. Ryan into marrying your daughter.
Now, I'm a pretty good judge of characters. Now, Lee wants to marry my daughter, Zelda. And of course, I know he's not marrying her for the land.
Mr. Robertson, that's not a good idea. Now, you know that marriages don't always work out. And if they go their separate ways, Mr. Ryan will have the land. Now, my advice to you is put the land in your daughter's name. That way, the land will always stay in the family.
No, no. I want Mr. Ryan's name on that contract.
So be it, Mr. Robertson. But I've got to give you my personal advice. After all, that's what you're paying me for.
Did you see that? He's putting that Ryan over his own flesh and blood.
Yeah, I would sure like to have some grandchildren so they can go on carry my name. Carry my name through.
Mr. Robertson, I understand that you like to hang around Lee Ryan. And you're always on Zelda about getting married. But you need to show more interest in your son Sammy. And this family.
I have some grandchildren. So they could go on and carry my name.
Yeah. I hear that you're gonna sign half of that land over to that stranger Ryan if he marries Zelda. I just don't think that's right.
Dad is really glad to see you stay home. You're just like a son to him.
Well, this feels just like home to me.
Stop by to see how you were making it.
Well, thank you very much, Jim. I'm glad you were concerned. Yep, 2 weeks already. Man, it's hard to take. Martha's not with us no more. It's sad. Real sad. Great girl. A real pal. She was there when I always needed her. She was a real partner. And my raising those two kids, Sammy and Zelda. I mean, what a mother. But it was sad the way she had to go. I don't know, I just can't get over it, man. I'm shaken up over it. But I gotta continue working around here. Gotta keep things rolling. But that's the way Martha would want it. Yeah?
I heard that Mr. Ryan is still with you.
Yeah. Yeah, he's still working for me. Nice boy. Nice boy.
I thought it over. And I'm not going to run for the next election. And I'll take that foreman's job if you'll have me.
You mean you're going to quit being our local sheriff? Never thought it would come to that end. You did a super job. People in this area think the world of you. You always had my vote.
You know, Zelda, I hear that Helen's in the hospital. What's wrong?
Well, you know, they had been talking about the operation so that Helen could have the grandchildren Daddy always wanted, and they finally came to an agreement, and that's what's going on. Lee, I want to thank you for not fighting with my brother Sammy. I know you did it to help keep unity within this family.
Well, I can't really take a whole lot of credit. I mean, your brother has, so he's got a good right.
What's up, Dan?
You know, running this farm is not as easy as it looks. But I'm going to tell you right now, the way things are right now situated, the crop is actually my prop, my fault. I let the men off last week, which I shouldn't have let the boys go, I mean, you know. But anyway, that tobacco out there is starting to get ripe. And it's got to move. I mean, we got to move it quick. Otherwise, we're going to be in trouble with this stuff.
Well, don't worry, Dad. We'll have enough help. But all of them just can't work at the same time. So what we'll do, we'll run two crews. One in the morning and one in the evening.
You know what? It's a good idea. Now you know why I got you, my number one son.
Well, that being the case, I don't guess it'd bother Mr. Robinson too much about me leaving. I mean, after all, he sees his son now what he used to seeing me.
Thank you, ladies, for all that you've done for me. Well, I'm just going to have to break the news to Mr. Robinson. I'll have to be on the way.
I'm glad that you were here with us. I fixed you a little something for the long trip.
Thank you very much.
Lay, whenever you reach your destination, please keep in touch, and we'll write back, okay?
I will.
I've been cleared of that airport chute. I realize you like your little sexual fantasies. But when I'm gone, you need to be more precautious. You need to stay away from that window. I've been cleared of that airport shoot. I realize, you like...
You know, Helen, it's nice to get out like this and listen to the crickets and a nice walk and be together in the quietness of the farm and just look over the farm and all the farmland and walk around it and go back to nature and listen to the crickets and the birds sing with old Bubba coming along walking with us. Isn't it great?
It is. It's really nice.
Really great.
I just hope we don't have to lose part of this.
Me too. That's really got me worried. Seems like things are going so good, now here comes trouble.
I know. And you've worked so hard for your dad. And you've just given him your all.
No, it's just, I don't know what we're going to do, but it's really got me worried. It really has. I hope things will work out soon. If only that Ryan guy had not come into the picture.
Just some way to get rid of him.
Yeah, and Zelda seems to be so much in love with him. I hope it's some way that she can see the light and see what him for what he really is. But time will tell.
Whoever shall call on the name of the Lord will be saved. But that means you turn over your sinful ways. Give up your sinful ways and turn your life over to the Lord. What I want to announce is that my uncle Charles Wilson, he died in the hospital last night. He was attacked by one of these street gangs here in New York by demanding money for protection. There's nothing we can do for Uncle Charles outside of giving him a decent burial, but what it is, we can spread the gospel to help the living.
You know, Zell, there's something that we need to talk about. Zell, I tell you, I can't take this farm life. Getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, slopping the hogs, working the fields. I want to go back to the factory and work. I will marry you, but I want you to come with me.
Wait. This is the only life I've ever known. I'll marry you, but you've got to stay here and help me work the fields because this is all I've ever done.
want you to know that I bought the lock and put you on the tool shed.
Stickers all over. What'd you say about your tool shed?
I bought a lock and put you on the tool shed.
You did?
And locked up our tools.
Well, we've never done that before.
I know, Dad, but this day and time, you can't take any chances on somebody stealing our tools.
Well, I doubt it. But, after all, this is your place as well as mine, so whatever you do, it's fine with me.
Leroy's doing a good job on the farm for Mr. Robertson.
Is that right?
Yeah, he is. But I tell you, Mr. Robertson needs to pay more attention to Sammy.
Well, you know that I don't feel like that Sammy